Hello beautiful people, how's it going? I'm back with another video and today we are watching Mad Max Fury Road for the very first time. If you're new to the channel, hello, I'd like to show you this statistic. Almost 60% of my viewers are not subscribed, so you should consider subscribing. I'm a really big Tom Hardy fan and I also kind of like Charlize Theron, so I'm excited to see what this movie gives us. I know it's an apocalyptic movie, that's pretty much it. Let's get right into it. I have a feeling this one's gonna be a bit different.
My world is fire and blood.
Why are you hurting me?
So this is a post-apocalyptic world, right?
It was hard to know who was more crazy.
All I can hear is Bane.
Hello?
That's a really beautiful shot.
They are long dead.
Ugh!
I am the one who runs from both the living and the dead.
So we have zombies here in this world?
A man reduced to a single instinct.
It's amazing how these shots are just amazing shot after amazing shot. Oh my goodness, they're branding him. That was a really cool transition. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna love this film.
Max, is that you? Where were you?
That's so creepy. What is going on?
You let us die!
You let us die!
You let us die!
This is really horrifying. It's directed so well, I can't look away. Within 5 minutes, they've already built a world that I believe exists. I'm so sorry, but this is another beautiful shot. I'm gonna be repeating myself throughout this entire reaction. Honestly, you guys, honestly, it's been 5 minutes and they've already built an entire world while giving us amazing shots, introducing us to our main character fully. I'm just blown away. I'm not picking up on all of the symbolism, but I know this means something. Talk about excellent costume design, man. So all of these people bow down to this guy? They only follow him because he gives them food. These poor people are starving and thirsty. And I feel like he's taking advantage of that. He has access to all of this water.
Do not, my friends, become addicted to water.
Maybe I'm reading too deep into it, but this really says something about hierarchy and how it's built. How many Oscars did this movie win? Just look at these shots. Did it win for cinematography? Must have. I'm assuming that road has got a lot of fury in it. These shots are fantastic. I don't understand who, like, how?
We're heading east.
I guess she's a part of the rebellion. He's drinking breastfed milk.
She's going off-road into hostile territory.
Oh no, they found her.
Splendid.
It's the way the camera work in this movie is gone about. Something about it feels very fresh and new, even to today. And this movie was made 6 years ago, so I love it.
Where is she taking them?
She didn't take them, they begged her to go!
So did she take slaves that were his and he's mad about it? I guess that's it. Oh my god, that's Beast from X-Men.
She took a lot of stuff from Immortan Joe.
What stuff?
Breeders. He's prized breeders.
His slaves are called breeders? Does that mean they're sex slaves? Are you kidding me?
His job is blood bag. Right there.
I don't know what they were doing with Tom Hardy, but whatever it was, that was not good.
Got my blood, now it's my car.
What do they want from his blood? My god, why is he connected to him? This is crazy. Electric guitar that breathes fire on a giant vehicle in the middle of the desert. This is the best thing I've ever seen in my life.
He looked at me!
My God, they would do anything to get noticed by their leader.
He turned his head, he looked me straight in the eye! He was scanning the horizon!
This is so strange, they worship him, it's so disgusting. These are just cool shots after cool shots after cool shots, and I am just having the time of my life, and I'm so happy. Oh my goodness. The action set pieces in this film are done fantastically. They're really choreographed. It looks like a lot of effort was put into this. That looks practical. There is no way that was CGI, and I love that. What a fantastic shot. This is unbelievable.
She's ours! First we get the buzzards off her back!
I'm starting to feel like Charlize Theron's character is actually the main protagonist, not Tom Hardy. Yeah. What a shot. Wow. You guys. Oh, I'm assuming that's one of the slaves. This is so wild. I love it. How much money did they put into this film? All of this is real. None of this looks CGI. You know what? I think from now on, I'm just going to give you guys a look when I see a beautiful shot. I think that's the only way this can work without me getting annoying. You gotta be careful from sandstorms. I live here, I know what it's like. The best thing this movie accomplished was building a world that I believe to be real. That's the reason I'm into this film. I believe that everything that is happening in this fictional world is real. It's a visual masterpiece. I am blown away. Tom Hardy's versatility is amazing. Wow, Max escaped. He's free. So, his captor was using his blood. I wonder for what? Oh, he found them. That's disgusting. Are you kidding me? Now I recognize her. I knew I knew her from somewhere. She's Sam Witwicky's girlfriend in the third Transformers movie. It's really cool seeing Charlize Theron doing this action role. I don't understand why you would even attempt to want to kill her.
He's gonna be so grateful. We could ask for anything.
Why would Max want to help his captors? I feel so bad for these women.
You've already damaged one of his wives. How grateful do you think he's gonna be?
Exactly. You shot her for absolutely no reason.
Let's go.
I'm excited to see this dynamic play out. That's a really beautiful shot.
Now you traded him!
Oh no.
He's just a kid at the end of his half-life!
No! I live! I die! I live again!
They're merciful too. These women, no matter how much they've gone through, still remain to be merciful and good-willed people? Wow! That's inspiring.
We're not to blame!
And who killed the world?!
It really says something about blindly following someone, or blindly following an idea. This movie is trying to have a deeper message, and I really respect it for it. Do we trust this man yet? She is so cool.
I'm gonna unhitch the pod!
I really like her robotic arm. I think that's really sick. No, you're kidding. Now's not the time.
Oh my god, they're here and she's about to give birth. This is chaos. Oof. Oh, that's nasty. This is so wild, man. I love this film. I swear to god, wow. It must have been so fun filming this. Working on this film must have been such an experience for everybody involved. It's also worth mentioning that the score in this is phenomenal. I don't know who made it, but it's pretty fantastic. Wow, that's gonna put out the fire? That is phenomenal, man. These action sequences are awe-inspiring. I want to become a filmmaker and do something like this because of this movie. God bless. Yeah, he's not gonna shoot his wives that he loves so much.
I'll pike her in the spine. Keep her breathing for you.
Are you kidding? He's willing to kill people because he has been brought up to believe in this leader. He would do anything for him. It's actually nuanced. It's so sad. Did she die? Oh my goodness, thank God. No! What the hell? Are you kidding me? Ah, that made my heart hurt, bro.
Whatever happens, we're going to the green place. It's turning green.
No, Zoe, you're going to Gotham City. How does she not get this? Wow.
Stop doing that.
This is actually really sad.
If they don't get me, then the Night Fevers will.
As I said, it's really complicated. He wasn't necessarily a bad guy. He was just following orders from someone he believed in because it was all he knew. I find that very fascinating. I like that this story is somewhat nuanced and doesn't just give us a straight up hero and a villain. Even Charlie's Theron's character is a bit questionable at times. I love it. The color palette in this film is just insane. From oranges to dark blues, it's beautiful. Whoa! The contrast in the blue and the orange is just crazy. That was beautiful, man.
Your girl is breathing at last.
What about the child?
How is she alive?
Get it out!
Huh? No. Oh my god, how did he do that? How did he get it out?
He lost a baby brother.
Now he's furious. He lost his wife, and he lost his baby, so.
Don't breathe.
Oh my goodness. All these people want is just a little sense of calm and freedom. Those are a lot of weapons, man. What is up with these visions he's been having throughout the entire film?
I was taken as a child.
Of course she was.
This is the best shot I'll ever have.
And yet she's never given up. Amazing. Oh my god, do they know each other? What?
The crows. That creepy place with all the crows.
Wait, so the green place isn't here anymore? It's destroyed? This is so rough, man. This is so messed up. This is so painful, but I have to say it. What a beautiful shot.
You're more than welcome to come with us.
Well, I'll make my own way.
No, I like them together. Come on, give me one shred of happiness, please.
You'll go insane.
I am Gotham's reckoning.
Was this a child he was supposed to save or something?
Come on, Pa. Let's go.
Oh no, was it his daughter? He had a daughter that he was trying to save?
He wants to go back from where they came.
Citadel.
That would be difficult.
So we take the war rig and we charge it right through the middle of them.
That involves effort, though. I like the plan, but it involves a lot of effort, and you only get one chance.
It feels like hope.
Oh, I really like him. I felt so bad for him, man.
War rig! Set the war rig!
Here we go. It's time for war.
They're going back to the Citadel!
Get wrecked. Destroy the Citadel. Let's go. Free those people. No! Oh no!
Gotta back off! Engine one is gone. Two's about to blow.
My goodness. Huh, thank God. No! Why? No! No, 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 no! You're kidding. This is really cool and strategic, but I am so scared for my protagonists. Nice! No, no, not Zoe Kravitz, not Zoe Kravitz, I swear to God, bro. Whoa.
Take me.
Are you serious?
Peter, what are you doing?
Why? No!
Remember me.
What a great line. I guess that's it. He's dead. God bless you, Zoe. Oh, she died peacefully. God bless. Wow. Oh my goodness. No! No! No. I'm conflicted because it's such an honorable sacrifice and it's a brilliant way for his character to go out, but it does make my heart hurt.
She's exsanguinated, drained all her blood.
I'm so conflicted. It's a beautiful ending. I'm not happy about it, but it's beautiful. So I have to respect it. I love it. Oh wow, well, giving her his blood help?
Max. My name is Max.
That's beautiful. They made it. Get wrecked! And just like that, you freed all of these people.
She's back.
She's alive. Wow. They're letting all of the people up. Everybody. Wow. Freedom for all. God bless. What is this movie? It's beautiful. What a beautiful, perfect ending. Wow.
This is the third Tom Hardy movie that I've ever seen. I have seen The Dark Knight Rises, which I reacted to. I have seen Venom, which I reacted to. And now this. Tom Hardy is one of the most versatile actors I've ever seen. George Miller directed this film. I just looked him up. George Miller is also the director of Happy Feet. What? I love this film with all of my heart. It's a solid 10 out of 10. I swear to God, that is my opinion. That is my opinion. And if you disagree, that's totally okay. When I made a post saying that I would be reacting to this movie, some people said, best thing ever. And others said, this is the most overrated piece of crap ever. And I personally loved every second of it. I was really nervous going into it because that's what people told me. My channel, my viewers were split in halves and I didn't know what side I would land on. But of course, when you film a reaction, you really hope you like it because that is how I know that it's going to be a successful video. If I watch a movie that I don't enjoy, most likely people will not enjoy the reaction. For example, The Breakfast Club. I thought it was a complete disaster and I hated it and I still hate it. It's been a month. My mind has not changed. This film may be the greatest action film I've ever seen in my life. Ever. In terms of action, wow. It also has a very basic plot. The plot is simple, but the execution makes it feel so grand. In this post-apocalyptic world, these slaves just want to be freed. It's basic, but it works so well because it hits on so many beats that us as humans can relate to. This movie was real to me. Not to mention all of the beautiful shots. You guys know, beautiful shots are the reason I'm alive. I'm a film student and I love it. I love it so much. And so when I see a movie that is constant beautiful shots from start to finish, I am just amazed and I just had the most brilliant time watching this. This movie was a treat to myself. I really felt like I was blessing myself by enjoying my time watching this film. And I really hope you guys liked it too. I feel bad for anybody that didn't enjoy this movie. I swear. Not to mention Charlize Theron. Wow. I think the only movie I know her in is Snow White and the Huntsman. I'm really sorry. I think that's the only movie I know her in. I should probably look that up. I think that's probably wrong. I've probably seen her in something else. But it's really interesting seeing her in this action role. She was so powerful. And I think for a movie made in 2015, I think that revolutionized a couple of things. I'm not going to get into it because I know people really hate when I speak in a politically correct manner. But let's just say I think this role did a lot for the movie industry. I think Charlize Theron did that. Also, this movie was nominated for, I think, 10 Oscars and won 6 of them. God bless. I don't usually agree with the Oscars. The only time I ever really agreed with the Oscars was when The Shape of Water won Best Picture in 2018 or 17. I obviously also agree with, you know, the Oscars back then, but the Oscars over the past couple of years were just a complete train wreck, in my opinion. The Best Picture winners, for example, Nomadland. My God, I despised that film so much. I love Chloe Zhao. I loved Eternals. The Eternals Funko Pops are back there. I know you can't see them because it's dark, but trust me, all of the Eternals Pops are back there. But I hated Nomadland. So the fact that the Oscars gave this movie 6 wins makes my heart happy. It deserves it. George Miller deserves it. The cinematographer deserves it. Everybody who worked on this movie, including the score, wow. Makeup, visual effects, costume design. It's just flawless. It's a 10 out of 10 for me. But then again, that's just my opinion. If you disagree, that is totally fine. I love you all the same. Anyways, if you guys made it to the end of this video, comment, oh, what a day. What a beautiful day. I love you all so much, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, guys.